Hello friends, today I am going to discuss with you history of English literature, and this is prescribed in BA part first levels, but for BA part second students should also know about the history of English literature. And in my previous lecture I talked about Renaissance period and also period from the 14th century, and today I am going to talk about Elizabethan poetry, and I talk about narrative and Elizabethan lyrics and song. And in my lecture I talked about that this period was a golden age in English literature, where lyrics and song developed in this period, and this period was actually the golden period of English literature. And in the first part of his narrative poetry, narrative ballad and narrative part also developed in this age. Pastoral poetry and courtier or official poetry developed in this age, and we have now seen that this age was very beautiful in the sense that it was a great age. Elizabethan lyrics and song were popular in this age, and next sonnet and sonnetiers and sonnets were imported from Italy to England, with Surrey were the men who brought them to England and developed. And the form of sonnet was very popular, and Wit and Surrey were the men who actually invented the new form, and Shakespeare and Spenser were the men who used them in their dramas, and also they wrote poetry or sonnet. Sonnet actually is a lyric poem that can be sung, and a line, this is a poem of 14 lines. Sonnet and sonnet here. So this poem, this age is popular in or rich bears Sir Thomas Rich it in early Elizabethan poetry, and Earl of Surrey made potential change in Italian form and invented English form of sonnet. Later on, this form of sonnet was practiced by Shakespeare with a skilled hand, therefore it is also called Shakespearean sonnet. And Wit sonnet are inferior quality of those of his friend Surrey. The songs and sonnets of both were jointly published in total miscellaneous in 1556. After Wit and Surrey, sonnet remained forgotten and neglected for a number of years, till the publication of Philip Sidney sonnet sequence of Aristophel and Stella, that is a popular poem and published in 1591. Elizabethan sonnet reached its full flowering in the hands of Shakespeare. Other prominent sonneteers of this age are Edmund Spenser, Henry Constable, Samuel Daniel, and Barney Bernice Michael Drayton. Spenser also made new innovation in the form of English sonnet, that is called Spenserian sonnet. Elizabethan sonnet were highly musical, and love was the major theme of those sound sonnets of all the major sonnet writers of 16th and 17th century. Wit wrote 96 sonnets, Spenser 88, Sidney 110, Shakespeare 154, and Milton 24. And next is licentious poetry. And despite the immense endeavor of the social reformer like the Rosa, H.M., Italian voluptuousness and sensuality exercised a great effect to English poetry, and there grew a whole body of licentious poetry, chief of which are Christopher Marlowe's Hero and Leander, Shakespeare's Venus and Aronia's The Rape of the Lucrece. Those such type of poems scandalized the moralists they became of the daily reading of fine talents of young festival the beaming. And next is silver poets of the 16th century, Sir Thomas Whitbrandy Hogarth and Earl of Surrey, Sir Philip Sidney, Sir Walter Raleigh, John Davies and Christopher Marlowe are known as the silver poet of 16th century because their poetry was characterized by silver tinge, eloquence. All of them wrote short poems like lyric sonnet, ballad, carol, and elegy, epitaph. And although the poetical work of these poets had many qualities in common, all of them had their individual style. All of them had the connection with the court. Therefore, their poetry reflected the intrigues and treasures of the court life. And it was through Witt and Surrey that influence of the Italian Renaissance reached England and fertilized English poetry. Particularly, love poetry was developed in this age, but there are also some devices or some form were also written at the time, except lyric or sonnet, ballad, choral, and elegy. Elegy is a sad song also developed in this age, and sonnet is the most popular of all the form of the poetry. Ballad is a narrative poem and mostly written for some courtmen or some king, and some but pastoral poetry were also dedicated to ballad. And so here we have now learned about the five part of the Elizabethan poetry, how poetry developed in this age, and who were the poets who contributed in this age. So student, I have now talked about some part of the of English literature of Elizabethan age. So today I conclude here, and I will discuss prose developed in Elizabethan age. So till then, thank you very much.